Can you spot any difference between these two potatoes? Well, this one is a GMO, this one isn't. GMO is short for genetically modified organisms. Here we have a genetically modified potato, also called a transgenic potato. To better understand, let's get a little closer.
Like the non-GMO potato, in this one, the genetic material was altered. But how? Let's see.
Supporting the vascular invertase gene prevents sugar reduction, therefore producing browning and acrylamide formation, a potential carcinogen. In contrast, enhancing sucrose transporter genes increases sucrose flow into the tuber, making potatoes larger and tastier.
The crop was also engineered with the Bacillus thuringiensis gene, which produces a protein toxic to certain insects, conferring pest resistance.
If it is harmful to insects, it can be harmful to us.
And what if those altered genes mix with ours and we get allergies?
It's been proven that it only affects insects. Plus, it is impossible for those genes to mix with ours.
Additionally, the engineers introduced a resistant version of a gene from agrobacteria, enabling tolerance to glyphosate-based herbicides, so this trait is more commonly applied in soy and corn.
That means farmers will use more pesticide, which isn't good for the environment.
But if those plants cross with wheat and make invisible wheat?
So, the use of glyphosate will increase, and I heard it's a probable carcinogen.
It can also destroy ecosystems by contaminating water and land.
Those are true concerns. As scientists are working on avoiding these bad effects, they work on buffer zones and persist editing techniques, learning from recombinant DNA to CRISPR-Cas9.
GMOs are always tested before going on the market. However, risks always remain. They have proven to play an important role in ensuring food security, yet their impact depends on us. Now you, what do you think?